Hello viewers, welcome to our channel Planning Physics. Today we are here with the topic of how we will check, count or see or generate the lag report from our Primavera project schedule. So what is lag or lead in Primavera Physics? Lag time is a duration that is added to relationship link to impose a wait time between an activity and its successor in Primavera P6. If the lag is a positive duration, then the successor activity will have a wait period before starting. If the lag is negative duration, also called a lead or lead time, then the successor will overlap the predecessor activity. The good practice is that you must assign your activities a positive lag. The negative lag is not counting in planning strategy in the good manners, but it is somewhere difficult situation, it's acceptable. Lag can be applied to any relationship type to help you model your project work and any waiting period between activities. Lag are an part of program elevation review technique that we are using to build the CPM schedules. So why you should avoid using relationship lag in Primavera P6 schedule? So there the deal with the lag and lead times in Primavera P6. Relationship lag is a very convenient tool to help us model our work in Primavera P6. Using lag on dependencies can be very helpful add in period of wait or non-work or even to create overlapping activities. However, as I already described, we have to focus on the positive lag only, which we have already allowed from our client. So let's move forward to our topic. I will show you how we can generate our lag report in Primavera P6. Open your project and go to the tools. In the tools, you can see here there is a reports. Go to the reports, click on the reports. Report window is opened and now you will go to the add button here. Click on the add. Yes, create or modify the report. We want new report. Next, click on the activity relationships and next. This dialog select additional subject area remains same. Next. In the columns, we will remove unnecessary columns here and we will add more columns here. Predecessor ID, predecessor name, successor ID, successor name. Close that window. Move lag at the end. Apply and OK. Group and sort by. Here, if you want to display option, you can also show grand total, summarize, whatever you want, you can show here. But the necessary thing is that you have to uncheck that indent. Apply, OK. And filter is very important. You have to understand very clearly that filter. All work is depends on that filter. All report. Go to the all of the following and lag. Here you have the option is equal, greater than or equal, less than or equals, not equal to, within the range of, within the, is not within the range and within the range. You can set it as that. Greater than, suppose that I want here 0 days, 5 days. You can put your limitation which client allowed you. 0 days. Apply and OK. Next, here we will write lag report. Lag report. Next, run report. Here you have option, two main options. One, you can print directly from here as a PDF, and you can also generate a Excel file as well. First of all, we will generate an Excel file, delimited text file. Here you have any notes, you can write it. Okay. The report is creating. Now we will go to the run report again and click on the print preview. Okay. You can see here, this is our lag, which is greater than the zero to the all activities. Here you can see your lag and you can print that file as a PDF or as a to the directly your printer, and you can also set your headers, footers, as I already described in my too many lectures, videos, tutorials. You can check and you can print that one. We are printing that as PDF as well, and we are already have here the Excel file. You can see here activity name, predecessor and successor activities. You can see here as you manage the columns there, these are the activities and here is the lag. Now you can filter that activities. Simply apply the filter here and you can check and comparison with your schedule where you need to minimize your lag. And the second is, okay, this one is our in PDF form. If we zoom it, you can see here the same all data is here as well. Minimize that one. If you want to see the lag in which is in negative value, go to the filters and is less than zero, or you can apply any other filter. Apply OK. Next, run report as a print preview. Okay, now you can see here the lag is in negative values. This is how you can manage or generate your lag report. To understanding that lag report, you have to minimize the your lag of your activities. Next, finish. Yes, it's completed. And how you can see the individual activities lag, show your bottom layout, and here you can see in predecessor there is a lag option, this one, and in successor is this lag option. You can manage by clicking this one. You can add, write, and this one also. In relationship, you can see here the lag option is here, and as well the lag option is here. You can manage by this one. This is how we can generate a separate lag report, or we will manage our lag of activity after watching that report, analyzing that report to our activities. Hopefully you understand our today's tutorial. Please like, share and comment on our channel. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.